What's up, tribe? So I just got back from a brunch, so my hair is a little crazy and I'm pretty sure I got an eyelash falling off, but you know what? I am coming on here to do the Ask the Tribe segment. It's basically when I give you guys a question of the week and you guys give me your short and sweet answer. Today's question of the week is, what is something your crush did that made them instantly unattractive, okay? Now, keeping with my promise, every time we have a new question of the week, I'm going to give you guys my scenario, okay? So what did my crush do that made me automatically find them unattractive? I used to have a crush in middle school and I really, really liked this guy. He already was not a looker, I'm gonna be so honest with you, but I just really liked his personality and we just really, really vibe. And now this is so shallow and so like, stupid, like as an adult, like I'm looking back like, really sis, like really? But I mean, it's not like I was ever gonna marry this dude, but it was recess time and he had a whole bunch of, and bless his little heart because he cannot control this, like he was a child, like this is his parents' fault, but both of his legs were covered in bed bug bites, like scarring and just fresh bites, and like they were just covered with bed bug bites, and it just turned me off completely. I was like, no ma'am, no sir, I'm good on that. Another instance that I had was just something so stupid where like a guy bent over to do something and I saw their butt crack and I was like, yeah, no thank you, Mr. Plumber Man, peace. So I'm gonna get into you guys' stories because I'm pretty sure all of these are gonna be like dumbass little reasons, like immature reasons that we've all done it. Rican Bruja says, he started blasting his music on a speaker when we were walking down the street. I used to hate those people in high school where they would have the speaker backpack and just be walking around like, bro, nobody wants to listen to your soundtrack. Plus his fingernails were black.
What the?
Oh my God, that's one of my pet peeves too, when guys have dirty ass fingernails, because I'm like, my God, that is a UTI waiting to happen. Like, Simi says, they asked me to eat his ass and put my finger in his booty.
The behavior that you exhibited was whore-like. The whore jumped out.
Then when I said no, he had the nerve to catch an attitude and tell me girls don't be doing what they need to do as a woman. That's why men go out and cheat.
Shut your goddamn ass up.
Sir, what you're saying is you want a wife. You want a wife. Because you can't be going around to nobody's girlfriend and asking them to casually eat your booty. Look, I am not kink shaming. I understand that, you know, men can get stimulation by doing that as well. But if that's what wifey material is, well then just count me out. Like, just count me out then. Nyla says, LOL, he was a misogynist. Yeah, that's happened to me a few times where it's just like, and I can tell, like, if you're in the LGBTQ plus community, like, that's a lot of deal breakers because it's just like, when you are interested in men, specifically sometimes straight men, they be doing that weird misogynistic shit or they be like homophobic shit because they think that you would be okay with it. And it's just like, no, I'm part of that community as well and you're trash, like. Emma says, having no money and not being able to pay for anything. Yeah, that turns me off too, because it's like, why even go out anywhere if you're not, if you don't have any money? Like, I'll chill with you in the house and you can, you get what I'm saying? If I know you like that, because I ain't going to nobody's fucking house that I don't know. But you guys get what I'm saying. Like, there's ways to wine and dine a girl without spending any money. But if you just have no money, period, like.
Grow the fuck up.
Lynn says she was straight, the end.
Ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
Mackenzie said, on the first date, he stopped the car in the middle of the street by a parking lot to play with a stuffed toy that someone had tied to their bumper. What was the reason?
What was the reason?
Verano says, Shorty begged me to be with her, but I wanted to take things slow. So instead, she got a boyfriend and then tried to cheat on him with me? That's more than a turn off. That's more just, yeah, I'm not about to fucking, you know, tolerate certain things. Lori says, he accidentally ate my food, so I accidentally threw a basketball upside his head during gym class.
Nigga, no.
Y'all are some violent ass little kids. Just hitting people with basketballs and shit in class, just... What the fuck? Kaylee said he had an Asian fetish. Ooh.
So sick.
Especially Japanese. And he also said he disliked mixed Asian people like me because we ruined the pure Asian bloodline. Let me guess, he's not Asian. That's a turnoff for me too. Like when people try to like fetishize like my ethnicity or just the fact that I'm multiracial, like that shit turns me off immediately because I'm just like, bro, you don't like me. You just like bitches that look like me. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, or you just like the idea of a, you get what I'm saying? Multiracial or in ethnic or, oh my God. Whenever guys say the word foreign, make it fucking stop. I know that there are some girls out there that like stuff like that, but me, no. Like, don't do that. It immediately turns me off because all it lets me know is that you're just fetishizing like, no ma'am, no sir. AK says, he seemed not to understand the concept of time management and showed up late when we made plans to see each other. That gets on my fucking nerves also. My rule of thumb, guys, and I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys already do this, I hit them up 24 hours before we're supposed to be there. Are we still on? Are we still going? You get what I'm saying? Because I'm not about to get dressed and showered and show up somewhere and be like, what the fuck? Like, so if you guys have plans with anybody, whether it's a date, friend, whatever, I always double check 24 hours in advance. But if you have like close friends, you know, you don't gotta do shit like that, but you get what I'm saying. Art Ho said, he and a group of guys said they would only consider getting to me because if they married me, they would be related to my brother. My brother was hella popular and I was introverted as hell. Definitely murked my self-esteem back then.
Oh bro, I'm gonna knock your sister out because you're so cool, dude. I just wanna be part of your fucking bro family, bro.
Does it never occur to them, like, okay, yeah, he may be popular, but maybe he cares about his fucking little sister. You ever thought about that? Maybe he doesn't want his little sister getting dogged the fuck out by fucking losers like you. Here go Destiny with this fucking novel. Talk about, this is kind of long. Guys, please keep it short and sweet. She says she's gonna do her best to get to the point. I was talking to this guy and we'll call him Colton because that was his name and fuck him. Well, that is that fucking hurt. I used to know a guy named Colton and we just used to call him Cotton, but he's a really nice guy. So not all Coltons are bad, okay? I told him I couldn't hang out because my cousin was in town, so I would be spending time with him. So I get a knock at my grandma's door and my grandma opens it and tells me Colton is here. I step outside and ask him what's up and he says, I knew you weren't with your cousin, you little whore. In front of grandma?
Electric chair.
And just as my grandma opens the door, he smacks me across the face. All while my 8-year-old cousin is sitting at the dining room table. What the fuck? Oh, hell no.
Lock that bitch up.
So my grandma tells him to leave and he does. I would have called the police. I would have called the fucking police. The second I would have seen him put his hand across your face, the cops are being called. Cause I'm not gonna put my hands on nobody else's kids, but what we're not about to do is fucking that. What the fuck? Like, how old were you when this happened? Like, were you a kid or were you an adult? Like, what the fuck is going on? This man needs some help. I feel like that happens to a lot of us though, where it's like we have a crush on somebody and then we find out that they're fucking batshit crazy. Like, usually that happens with attractive people. I've noticed that, like, when I was single and I would talk to people, it would always be the most attractive people, and I would be like, why are you single? Like, I'm not getting it. Oh, you crazy. Bree says he's married in his 50s with dentures and he was my supervisor and an asshole and a Libra, hashtag Virgo ting. So you had a crush on him, but then you found out that he was married and in his 50s, you been knew he had dentures, sis, don't play. And you been knew he was your supervisor, but Jesus, that married thing. Mojo says disappearing for an entire 2 weeks and then pretending like nothing happened. Those are the worst type of fucking people. Like, those are the worst fucking, like, especially when you left on a bad note. Like, why would you just go ghost like that? I don't know what's going on. Like, that would make me definitely not like somebody, like, instantly. Because if we're in the talking stage and you go ghost on me for 2 weeks, that just lets me know, like, it's not gonna work. Gail says, dude grabbed my bag of chips and poured hot sauce on them without asking me because he said I would like them better that way. Well, I think it is rude that he did that, but girl, you're missing out. Put that hot sauce on your chips. That bitch is really good. And all my vegan people out there, Brad, if you want a little hack, because Lay's chips are not vegan, I get veggie straws and then I get hot sauce and then I do, and I have vegan hot sauce that I got off Amazon. It's the same taste and it's a great unhealthy treat to have. So, but I would never just go up to somebody and do that to them. You get what I'm saying? But he did that because he said he would like it better that way. Then randomly ran his hand down my face and told his friends he could just do things like that.
What the fuck is going on in here on this day?
That is so fucking humiliating. Like, why would he do that? Talking about, look, I got a girlfriend, guys. Look what I can do. Like, what?
Grow the fuck up.
Alicia says, colorism. Even the celebs you have a crush on, the colors be so bold to present their hate, for darker skinned women and don't give a fuck how you feel about it. We hate to see it. Just to piggyback off of what I said earlier with the whole multiracial thing, like that goes hand in hand into it as well. How like when guys come up to me and they say like certain things and they always say, look at her, but I bet you don't have to deal with that because you're light skinned or something like that. And it's just like, bro, she looks beautiful and just fine, and being light skinned has nothing to do with what the fuck you just said. Y'all know them type of people. Y'all know them fucking weird backwards ass conversations that they be trying to have with them fucking selves. They think I'm gonna take it as a compliment just because I'm light skinned, and it's just like, bro, what you said was gross as fuck. Like, you ain't get zero cool points with me. Like, the fuck? Kiara says, being so constantly friendly with other females, friendly enough to cheat on 5 different females, and friendly enough to walk around school with hella hickeys on his neck from who knows. Regret dating him, of course. Well, sis, that's not a crush. You actually dated this guy and then all that shit happened, okay? Like, I really hope you get turned off if someone cheats on you. Abrina says, when this bum ass little boy tried to have my best friend fight me.
And
did he not know y'all were best friends? And then why did he want you to get beat up? If you liked him, like, was it a one-sided crush? Like, how does that happen? So that is it for this week's question of the week. We didn't have a lot of entries, but that's okay. I'm gonna think of a juicier topic for next week. If any of you guys have an idea of what you would want the next question of the week to be, leave it in the comments below, or you can leave it in the forum, whatever's easiest for you. And if you want to be in the video, sign up for the forum. It is free 99. And just look out every Monday and Tuesday, you'll get a notification. Another perk of joining the forum is that you get notified when I post YouTube videos way faster than you will get notified if you ever get notified by YouTube. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I will see you guys tomorrow and have an awesome day. My ring just flew across the room. Bye.